I'm really excited about this Wall of Distinction project. The first logical step was to honor Coach McCurdy because he was, obviously, he's the kind of the father figure, the spokesperson for the program, pioneer, and really launched UNH as a nationally recognized women's hockey program back when there really wasn't a whole lot of attention being given to the sport. The next logical progression is to honor the teams. And when I walk the halls of the Whittemore Center here, there are Olympians, national team players, past and present, that adorn the wall outside our locker room. But I feel there's a huge void in terms of recognition of the history of our program.
IPA W champs, we had ECAC champs, we had national ACWHA champs, and all that kind of gets lost in the shuffle of the years of the program. So what we'd like to do is honor all those folks. And so on the plaques that will be installed on the wall, for instance, with scoring champs or team championships, they'll have the breakdown of, we won in the EAIWA in this year, and then we won in the ECAC in this year. So that, we were league champions, not in Hockey East, because that's what we are now, but in the leagues that were around then. It shows what a stellar history this program really has had.
The 30 years of excellence that were established here by those teams back in the 70s and then onward is something that we're all proud of. People talk about UNH women's hockey. They recognize it as the winningest women's college hockey program. These people played a role in that, no different than the role someone plays today. I think it's time to put that on the wall and celebrate it.
And the individual awards will be up, for instance, all league players, and we've had all league players for as long as we've had leagues, and for each individual all league player, we'll have a little plaque on there with their name and the years that they were all league in that league. Players of the year, rookie of the year, most valuable players in the league, all have their names engraved on there with the years and the league.
There's a need in people to leave a legacy, to pass a torch, whether it be to their children, alumni, to today's current athlete, let's say in our program. And I believe that legacy is a gift and one that we need to put on our walls, we need to adorn our building with, we need to celebrate our program.
This year's project is this wall, and we decided to try to make it a one-year project, which may be a big thing, and it all depends on the kind of help that we get from you, our friends and members. We're trying to raise the money this year as a project to get this up by the beginning of next season, and hopefully with your input and a little bit of help and signing on the dotted line, maybe we can raise that money.
So what the alumni who played here did is they established the sport as something that could be a pursuit at any major university if the school had the desire, the funds, and the intent to support it.
Monies that come in for the wall are not monies just going to the Friends of UNH Women's Hockey. There's a separate fund that has been started for this, and it's dedicated money. So if you'd like to make a donation specifically for the Wall of Distinction, please do so. Please note on your check, you can make it out to you, Friends of UNH Women's Hockey, but it should stick on the subject line, should include Wall of Distinction.
day, we walk into this building and last week and here comes Harvard to town, and you know, you're watching hockey played at a level that I'm sure would have astounded people 30 years ago. And it wouldn't be that way if it weren't for these pioneers.
I hope we can all join together in this an active participation as friends of women's hockey, and we don't forget where we came from. And,